2015 Tuckahoe Seniors Annual Bazaar. We're here at Father Fada Hall at Assumption Church, and we have a great crowd today. The weather's a little bit blustery, but
It doesn't seem to have kept people at home. For those of you who haven't been here, please come on down next year. This is a great sale. This is our main fundraiser, and we use the proceeds mostly to fund our bus fund so that the Tuckahoe seniors can go on our day trips and we can keep the cost down. They don't have to pay for the bus because they've raised the money for the bus fund here. I know you probably at some point you will go around, or maybe you've already seen all the various tables here. We have a number of major fundraising efforts here going on. We have a white elephant table. We have a bake sale table, used jewelry sale table. We also have a number of raffles going on here, a 50-50 raffle and a gift raffle. We've got over 60 gifts donated by a lot of very generous merchants in the Tuckahoe, Eastchester area and Bronxville, and we're very appreciative of that. And we also have our cash raffle over here. You get a chance to win $250, $150, or $75. And then lastly, we've got a lot of food items. Come down here for lunch. This year we've got hot dogs, meatball sandwiches, sausage sandwiches, and beverages. And we I want to thank Vito and Michelle Pinto, who donated and made all the meatball sandwiches and sausage sandwiches. As I said, we are celebrating our 45th anniversary this year. We're the oldest continuously operating senior center in Westchester County. And we had a great gala lunch back in June. There are many organizations, many people that support us that I really want to thank. In particular, the Community Fund, which is a generous donor to our parent organization, the Senior Citizens Council. For those of you who aren't familiar, the Senior Citizens Council of Bronxville, Eastchester, and Tuckahoe, basically they run the Tuckahoe Senior Center and the Bronxville Senior Center. I also want to thank the town of Eastchester, Supervisor Colavita, and all the staff in Eastchester and Gilda Press. The town, Village of Tuckahoe, Mayor Eklund, our liaison, Greg Luisi, all the staff at Village Hall, especially Jackie and Camille and David Burke and the Department of Public Works, who help us put this event together. In addition to this fundraiser here, in conjunction with it, I should say, we also have our journal that we put out. We raise a lot of money with local vendors and merchants that take ads. And I encourage you next year, if you get solicited, it'd be great if you're watching this and you want to take an ad out in our journal. We raise quite a bit of money for that too. So the proceeds from the journal and the proceeds from this event mostly fund our transportation fund. It's a great afternoon, and I also want to thank everybody here that has worked so hard, all the committees here. Arlene Gruber does the journal, and that's a huge effort. We had a new decorating committee this year, and if you look around, we have a great display over here. I think you may have seen it already. Our gift bag raffle, we have a very talented team that spent a lot of time putting the decorating together, our fall theme. And then we've got all these other committees here, the raffle committee, the 50-50 committee, the jewelry committee, the kitchen, the elephant, white elephant sale, the bake sale, and I hope I haven't forgotten anybody. So I want to thank all of them for all their efforts, and hopefully you'll get to meet the various people at the tables here. So thank you for coming.
For those of you may know that we used to operate out of 4 Union. We moved over here to Father Fada Hall, and which is part of the Immaculate Conception
Assumption Church. And so I also want to thank the parish of the Immaculate Conception and the Assumption Church for allowing us to use this beautiful meeting space. We've been here for 2 years. And we also want to welcome Father Sorgi, the new priest over at Immaculate Conception, who's in charge. And again, welcome to the Tuckahoe Annual Bazaar. Thank you.
Good afternoon. This is Greg Luisi here, your local village trustee here at Father Fada Hall, where today the seniors are holding their annual bazaar. And this year marks the 20th anniversary that they are holding this bazaar. As I've been told by my dear friend, Faye Blasey, the bazaar originated at the Tuckahoe Community Center way back in 1996. Then it moved to 4 Union Place. And here we are today where the Tuckahoe seniors meet every Tuesday and Thursday at Father Fodder Hall at Assumption Church. And here with us today is one of the queens of the Tuckahoe seniors, truly a wonderful person, Faye Blasey.
Thank you so much. Well, I've been here 20 years. I started in 1996, but I think I really have to train some new people because I'm going to retire. Thank you.
And just before we began the broadcast, Faye was showing me her records going back to 1996. What a record of how much money she made selling jewelry going back 20 years. And joining us here is the mayor of Tuckahoe, Mayor Eklund.
Well, thank you, Greg. And I'll tell you know what? Faye, this would help us solve our budget problem. I'll tell you what, no, thank you so much. You know what? Tuckahoe is so fortunate to have not only wonderful seniors, but great volunteers. And Faye, that's a great, great scorecard, I'll tell you. So it's wonderful. So it's so nice of you. Thank you, Faye. I'm so happy that you're here this year, too.
Yes, I know you've been here for many, many years, of course. And we're going to see you many more years to come, too.
I hope so, but I doubt
it. We will. Oh, Faye.
I hope so.
All right, so we walk around to a couple other vendors here?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, well, we're here with Lennox Ali, the bag man, right? You don't mean...
Call me whatever. Don't call me late for lunch.
Well, thank you so much for being here today. Can you tell us a little bit about what you're selling?
A variety of things I have here. We have handbags, we have scarves, we have dresses, we have, just name it, wallets, we have, you know, midway, low and high, not high, mm-hmm. but everything is affordable.
Affordable.
And I'm very happy that the Senior Center invites me here every year for the past 3 years.
Wonderful.
And I enjoy giving, and I'm, of course, I enjoy receiving also.
That's right. Well, Lennox Ali, thank you so much for being a part of the Tuckahoe Senior Bazaar.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
And good luck today.
Thank you. Same to you.
Well, we're at a very, very busy table here. I'll tell you what, they're selling it right underneath our nose here. And we've got some seasoned veteran people who have been working at the Tuckahoe Senior Bazaar for many years. Arlene, how many years have you been doing this?
Probably about 5 only.
Okay.
And I started it in Union Place with Barbara Stiers. And she asked me to help her with the senior journal. The other person that was doing it couldn't do it anymore, and I took it over, and I've been doing it myself ever since. And it's very successful, and we thank all the vendors who have been, taking ads and answering my letters. And it's been a wonderful fundraiser. It really is good. And lovely place here.
You know, it's the biggest fundraiser for the Tuckahoe seniors, and let me tell you what, you do a great job. It is a lot of work. She's not telling you how difficult it is. It is a lot of work to put a journal together each year. Even though there's a learning curve that she's gotten past, it's still a lot of work. So thank you so much.
Oh, you're quite welcome. It's for a worthy cause, and we're all enjoying it, the results of it.
And I'm happy to take an ad in it each year,
yes.
Of course.
Years.
Tell us now.
I'm here 22 years since I retired.
Is that right?
Yep. In fact, I was here before that, but I couldn't come all the time. But otherwise, 22 years I've been here.
Now let me ask you, in 22 years, do you think it's grown? Has it gotten smaller? What do you think?
Oh yeah, it's got. We only had enough for the 4 Union Place, which was small. Mm-hmm. We have 159 now members. Mm-hmm. So it has grown a lot.
So the membership has grown and the bazaar. Has the bazaar gotten a little bigger too?
No, I think it's about the same,
okay.
Really. The pocketbook people were coming when we were down in 4 Union. it was a gentle, a man, at, I mean, a woman at one time. And I'm trying to think, that's new. And so is, what's her name? Oh, I can't think of her name.
Okay.
She's always Libby.
Okay. Oh, yes. Yes. Libby.
Those are all handmade. Okay. They're all handmade aprons. So.
Okay.
I didn't know. And did you go to the kitchen yet?
No, I haven't made it that far yet.
Because Jenny.
Save the best for last.
Jenny has been there the longest.
Oh, wow.
She's been doing that for years.
Yes.
And during the day, during our 2 days that we come, we're here about 10 after 8 every Tuesdays and Thursdays, and we prepare the coffee and all that. She's head of it though, and I help her.
Well, thank you so much for donating your time here. I'll tell you what, it's for a very worthy cause. Thank you for all the years you put in.
And it's enjoyable because we go to different places, mm-hmm. And we have, sometimes we have little parties here, so it's really nice.
And I'm happy you have a new home here at Father Father Hall.
Me too.
Yes.
Me too. We even have our up here too now.
That's wonderful.
Which is wonderful.
That's great. Thank you.
You're welcome.
For those of you who don't know me, I'm Jennifer Vetremile, the director of Tuckahoe Center. I want to welcome everybody here. Thank you for coming out on this blustery day and joining us here in this important fundraiser. I just want to very quickly thank some of our community partners. As many of you know, we are celebrating our 45th anniversary this year. We are the oldest continuously operating senior center in Westchester County, and we had a wonderful 45th anniversary luncheon in June. As many of you know, or may not know, the Tuckahoe Senior Citizens is part of the Senior Citizens Council of Bronxville, Eastchester, and Tuckahoe. They are a parent organization. The Senior Citizens Council runs Bronxville Senior Center and Tuckahoe Senior Center. And without them, we would not exist. They are an important contributor to us. I also want to thank the Community Fund, who also generously donates to the council, and which allows us to provide a lot of our activities. In addition, I want to thank the Village of Tuckahoe, Mayor Eklund and Greg Luisi, and the Village Hall, clerks Jackie and Camille and David Burke. There are a lot of people over at the Tuckahoe Village Hall who help us out. And also, I would like to thank the Town of Eastchester, Supervisor Colavita, and Gilda Press, again, who are major supporters of us. And last, I want to thank the parish of the Immaculate Conception and the Assumption Church that provide us this wonderful meeting space. And it has really been instrumental. We moved here 2 years ago, and I think many of you can attest to the new vibrancy in this organization since we moved over here. So again, I want to thank everybody here. I want to thank all of our community partners. Please continue shopping. We're going to do a drawing. We're going to start in two parts at 2 o'clock. We'll start doing our gift drawing. We'll try to do it quickly, and I'll say a few more words then. But again, welcome to the Tuckahoe Seniors Annual Bazaar. Thank you.
Now we have one of the nice things, we get some beautiful handmade crafts here, and we're going to talk to Libby and ask, Libby, can you tell us a little bit about what you have made here today?
I've made baby's bibs, children's smocks for nursery school and kindergarten kids, adult aprons, toddler aprons, kids' aprons, all kinds of aprons.
Now how long does it take you to make this? Are you working for months on this?
I've been working since last year.
Oh.
In between other things that I'm doing. So I'm always working on something.
Well, thank you very much for taking a booth here. It supports our seniors, and I know you always support the Tuckahoe seniors, so thank you so much.
You're welcome.
All right, the best table of the day is right here. I always hit this table before I go home. Can you tell us your names and tell us how long you've been doing this?
I'm Priscilla Nuzzi. I've been doing it for 15 years.
I'm Ruth McKee, just doing it for 2 years.
It's
the sweetest table in the town.
Oh, it sure is. And I notice a lot of this is homemade.
That's right. Most of it is. We just got a few people that can't do the baking, and they bring in store-bought. But other than that, It's homemade.
It looks wonderful.
Yes, I have one in my hand.
Oh, yes. Thank you so much. That's a long time for you to be doing some baking for the seniors in Tuckahoe.
Right. I enjoy it.
Do you notice more people come each year? What do you think?
Well, the weather, held back a lot of people, but we do very well ordinarily, except for when the weather is so bad,
Well, we needed the rain this year. Unfortunately, it came on the day of the Senior Bazaar, we do welcome the rain this year.
Yes, we needed it.
So thank you so much for doing all the baking you did. Thank you both.
Enjoy it.
You know, one of the nice things we have at the Bazaar here, of course, other than the sweet table that we're are going to be visiting and we've actually just left, is every year they have the best hot dogs. They have a wonderful food table here. And we have such great volunteers who actually help sell tickets for this. Tell us a little bit about that.
About what, the tickets?
Well, you're selling tickets and the food is made in the back?
We're selling food tickets, we're selling meatballs, and we're selling sausage and peppers and hot dogs, water and soda. And there we have cakes, you know that.
Of course. So,
and it's been a wonderful time coming here twice a week, and at least I have something to do.
And lots of things to do. Tell us what you did for many years, because I know.
I was a delicatessen owner.
And you could tell us where, right?
I was on Lincoln Avenue in East Chester, right by the high school.
Faye's Deli. All my life going and walking up there, we would always sneak into Faye's Deli, come out at lunch and get a meatball hero.
If you had any money, you ate anyhow.
That's right. You're absolutely right.
I am in
right.
Facebook, like 150 pages. And I have well wishes from all my patients, my customers.
And I'm so glad you stayed in Tuckahoe.
Okay. I've been here my 91 years.
I know.
I've been born here.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
Thank you
for volunteering. It's very nice that you come out.
I'm here to help.
Thank you. For
whatever. I don't like that guy. It's all right.
That was nice.
Thank you very much.
Well, this is where it's happening. This is where all the action is, right here in the kitchen. And I don't mean to crowd everybody out. I'll tell you what, there's an awful lot. Can you tell us a little bit about what you're cooking here today?
Oh, we have delicious sausage and peppers made by Michelle. And we have lots of meatballs and hot dogs. You name it, we've got it. And plenty of baked goods, homemade baked goods over there on the table.
Oh, we're hitting up the bake table, I can tell you that much. That's for
delicious.
Sure. How many years?
Homemade.
And how many years have you been doing this here?
20 years.
And you and yourself?
I'm fairly new. I'm just been here.
Okay, all right.
2 years, yes.
Michelle, you've been coming here quite often.
Oh, Michelle.
Michelle Pinto. Everybody knows Michelle Pinto. Thank you.
20 years.
20 years?
Yeah, let me get out of the way.
Oh, that's okay. Well, this is the busy spot, I'll tell you what, at the Tuckahoe Senior Bazaar. Thank you all so much. Thank you for doing this.
You're the one that told me that, two steaks.
I never said that. I would have never thought of that.
I don't know. All right. That's
well, they're the best hot dogs you can get in town. I'll tell you that much for today. That's for sure.
And I got two beautiful helpers, these two new girls.
They're new members of our Tuckahoe Senior, Pat and Diane, and they've been a great help.
Thank you so much.
A great help to
me. Thank you. We really appreciate it.
And Michelle with her beautiful sausages and peppers and meatballs. We're doing great, thank God.
Well, buy some.
That's right.
And those meatballs are legendary. Those meatballs are legendary. And the mayor and I are definitely going to have some after this interview.
Okay, good.
Well, thank you all. Busy place here.
Nice seeing you guys.
We're gonna get started. So earlier I thanked a lot of our community partners, and I just wanna say, Sheila Marcotte, Sheila's standing over there. Sheila, can you wave your hand? Sheila's here also, thank you. So, we talked about our community partners, and I also wanna talk about Tuckahoe Senior Citizens. I wanna thank the board, and please, board, raise your hand. Our president, Laura Sarasi. Our Vice President, Mary Iannitti. Denzel Francis, our Treasurer. Kathleen Burke, the Assistant Treasurer. Connie De Laurentiis, our Recording Secretary. Irene Norman, Membership Chair. And Faye Blasi, our Trips Chair. So I want to thank the board for their support. They make my life a lot easier. And I also want to now acknowledge everyone that has worked on this bazaar. You know, we've got a lot of committees here, A lot of people that make this effort happen and make this event a success. So again, some of these people are board members. Our cash raffle, Laura Sarasi. This is for the huge cash prize, it's $250. Laura ran that. The 50-50 raffle, I want to thank Denzel Francis, Alda Piccone, and Connie DeLaurentis. And Vivian Coughlin. The gift raffle, Mary Ionidi, Maureen Smith, and Rosa Fiore. And there are other people that have sat in, okay, on this that are assisting the committee members. The kitchen, Jenny Angelo, Michelle Pinto, Carol Palma, Pat Devlin, and Diana Winokur. Food tickets, Faye Camise and Georgina Walsh. Decorating, Rosa Fiore, Connie DeLaurentis, Jenny Ray, and Camille Spana. And this is a new committee this year, and you did a great job. Jewelry committee, Faye Blasi, Kathy Burke, Marie Marin, Angela Mondello, Sally Sinanti. Bake sale, Louise Campanelli, Priscilla Nuzzi, Jenny Ray, and Ruth McKee. White elephant sale, Betty Gallo, Joanne Sarazzi, Joanne Tyroler, Camille Spana, Eleanor Vichy. Patrons, Bernice Yancey. Journal, Arlene Gruber. And finance, Denzel Francis and Kathy Burke. I'd also like to mention, we need to thank Nature's Cradle and Twin Farms, who donated all these great, some of these decorations, the corn stalks and the bales of hay. Bales of hay. So, and it all looks terrific. And lastly, I want to thank our tireless worker, where is Vincent? Mr. Riley, I don't see him here, but I want to go on record thanking Mr. Riley, who really works hard, okay? All right, so if I didn't mention your name, I want to thank all the volunteers here that have participated. Thank you for your help. They're rolling and rolling. Item number one. Actually, you know what we'll do is, Mary, why don't you pick the first one? Mobile car wash coupons. Item number one.
Alda
Piccone.
Yes.
All right. Item number two, Harpo's. Oh, here you go. Harpo's, an oil change. Oil change, Harpo's.
All right, ticket number, the last three numbers, 719. They just bought them right now. 719, ticket.
8345, 719.
Yeah, she's there.
All right, yeah, so actually, yeah, come forward towards us and we can get the gift to you. Item number three, Cheryl's Hair Studio, a $35 gift certificate. Yeah. Sarah Belair. Is Sarah here? All right, that's item number three. Keep it. We're going to type
it.
She's
going
to. Item number. Yep. Item number four, an oil change from Rocco's Service Center. Gail Miranda. Is Gail here? Yeah, well, it keeps opening up and things are slipping out. We don't want that to happen.
Are you Gail?
You know what?
All right, Gail. Number four.
Okay, item number five. Michael's Barbershop says $17 men's haircut. Men's haircut. No, don't do that. Last three digits, 329, 834, 3329. Michael's Barbershop. Okay, can you come on up, and that's for Arlene Gruber. Okay, item number six, Villaggio's Pizzeria, two large pizza pies. Angela, 779-2385. Is this Angela Mondello? Okay, two large pizza pies for Angela. Villaggio's Pizza. Number seven, Epstein's, a $25 gift certificate from Epstein's.
That's all I wanted was two pizzas. Thank you.
Carol Miller. Is Carol Miller here? This is you? Okay, so. Who has Carol Miller here, Epstein. Here you go. A $55 gift certificate at G&G Styles Hairstyling. Last three digits, 992. 834-992. There's no name written on this. 834-992. That's you, Bobby Altman. Bobby Altman won it. Okay, $20 gift certificate, Zuccarelli's Deli, number nine. Could you twirl it? Kathy Levy. You want to take that to her? Okay. Here, type item number nine. Yep. Okay. Number 10. What's this? Okay, item number 10, Tap House, lunch for two at the Tap House. Steve Eklund, the mayor. All right, this is a $50 gift certificate.
What number, 11?
Item 11, the Quarry Restaurant. $50 gift certificate. Nice. Gift certificate. Peter, 374-7610.
That's my son-in-law.
Your son-in-law. It's Faye's son-in-law. That's item number 11. Okay, item number 12, Fast Frame, $50 gift certificate to Fast Frame. Mayor Steve, again, he must have bought a lot of tickets. He did, I'm told he bought a lot of tickets. All right, a $35 gift certificate to Luigi of Italy, hairstylist. Sheila Marcotte. Number 14, $25 gift certificate to Cornell's Hardware. Jared Yancey.
Is it Jared?
next one. Dinner for two at the Eastchester Inn. Dinner for two. Alza Bocconi. There you are. Okay, $25 gift certificate for C-Town, number 16. C-Town, $25 gift certificate. Ruth. Is this Ruth?
Yes, Ruth.
We have two Ruths. Ruth Airy.
Okay.
So that's item number 16, $25 C-Town certificate. All right, next item, a $25 gift certificate to Gina Marie's Chianti Ristorante. Marianne Frusciante. Frusciante, is that how you say it? Next item, a certificate for a haircut and a blow dry from Act One Hair Salon.
Yes, number
18. Initial AP.
Yes, that's Ann Pinto.
Ann Pinto. Oh, it's Michelle, okay.
Yeah,
it's
Michelle.
Is Michelle here now, or did she leave? All right, well, we'll put this is Michelle. Okay, I'll table that. Number 19, Mario's Hairstyling, a men's haircut. Let's see if this is Greg Luisi again. I don't know if you were, last year he won four haircuts. Actually, he won a haircut and a blow dry. So this is Kathy Levy again.
Okay, I'll take
it. Item number 19.
Right here, right here.
Item number 20, a manicure at Blue Nails.
You know, this really makes us good.
All right, this is a number, 834-3995.
8343995.
It's Bobby Allman again.
The four is, this is three and another one is four, I think. Yes.
Okay, next item. Item number 21, a $25 gift certificate to Tuckahoe Florist. Faye Blasi. Faye, you won a $25 gift certificate to Tuckahoe Florist. Okay, next item, a $25 gift certificate to Toscana Ristorante. Bent or Benny? Benny. B-E-N-I?
Let me see. That's Ben Ioniti, my son.
Ben Ioniti. Ben I. Okay.
Right. My son.
Yeah. Right. So that's number 22, right? Item number 23, a haircut and blow dry at Tuckahoe Coiffures. Jane Clark. Okay, item number 24, $25 gift certificate to Pulpatina Restaurant. Okay, I'm going to read some numbers. 834-3357. 834-3357. Is that person here? Is that Arlene? Arlene Gruber. Okay, a blowout, blow dry at Salon Navona. Oh, Andrukas. Is Mary Andrukas the same as Andrukas? Or is there a Marianne and an Ann?
She was complaining that we weren't
Oh, there you go.
Now we're on a roll. 46, I'm skipping ahead. 46, a cut and a blow dry from Salon D. Cut and blow dry. T. Argetto. And, I'm sorry, T. Angelo. Okay, next item. Number 47, right? Fluffin from Fluff and Puff. A gift certificate to get your dog groomed. Item number 47. And you know, if you get one of these gift certificates and you can't use it, maybe you can trade with somebody. Don't throw it away. Give it to somebody else, please. And this is Mr. Nick. Nick Sanzano. Do you have a cat or a dog, Nick?
I'll bring it to
you. Yes. Okay, next item, a $25 gift certificate to Piper's Kilt. Connie, you pick. Pat Devlin. Okay, next item. Another Fluff and Puff gift certificate to get your dog groomed. Number 49, Fluff and Puff.
Come on, Connie.
Jen Brown.
Oh, you scared me.
I think that's Denzel's, your family friend, right?
Denzel will take it.
Someone was asking if you don't have a dog, if you could get your hair done there at Fluff and Puff. I'd like to see that. All right, next item. Number 50, a $30 gift certificate to Odyssey Diner. Gail Miranda. Is Gail here? She left? All right, we'll call her. Oh, Gail, okay. Okay, next item, number 51, a $25 gift certificate to Stop and Shop. Kathy Levy. Kathy Levy. No, she's not. Next item, number 52, what did I say? Is that number 51? Number 52, Wild Orchid Florist, a $40 gift certificate to Wild Orchid Florist. Ruth. Get some beautiful flowers. Next item, this is for a $55 gift certificate for Flip Hair Salon. Michelle Pinto. Okay, next one, a $15 gift certificate for Teresa's Bakery. Number 54. Carla. I'll have to find out how much money Carla spent.
Yeah, that's the one in the kitchen?
No.
That was 54. Number 55, a certificate from Village Laundrette for 25 pounds of wash. I don't know how much. Is that a lot of clothes? I don't know. Angela. Next item, a $10 gift certificate from Ace Nails. On Mill Road. Number 56. Sarah Belair. Next item. A dry cleaning of one garment from 3D Cleaners. I would take a winter coat over there. If you win this, take a winter coat over there. That's find your most expensive item. Michelle Pinto. Item 59, a $100 gift certificate to Salon Ari. $100 gift certificate to Salon Ari. All right, sorry, I skipped one. We'll start with 58, two bottles of wine from Mill Road Wines. Sheila Landsberg, I'll call her up. Sheila is our liaison and she lives in Tuckahoe. I wanna get the facts straight here. She's on the council. Okay, this is number 59, the $100 gift certificate. $100 gift certificate from Salon Ari. Ralph Stuppel. Okay, we have number 60 from the Mill Road Carvels. Okay, the Carvel on Mill Road, they've donated three $5 certificates. Denzel Francis here. He is our treasurer. Oops, don't trip. This is a great prize. Thank you everybody for stopping by the 50-50 table. The winner is going to get $240. And Denzel's going to pick. I just saw this. It's Denzel Francis. I watched this. This is legit.
It wasn't fixed.
No, I watched this, guys. I shook it up, he shook it up, and that was it. And now we have the big cash drawings. We're going to be done here with this. So we have $75, $150, and $250. These are the raffle books that we sold that all the members were required to purchase. Laura Sarasi, our president, is in charge of that effort. We're going to start with a $75 item and move our way up. Keep twirling it. Okay, so this is the first cash prize of $75. The $75 winner is Dottie Calabro. Close it up. Now we're going to do $150. $75. Dominic Munsell. For $150. Dominic Munsell. Does anyone know Dominic? We have a phone number here. We'll call him. And I want to remind everybody, the proceeds of this event, most of it goes to fund our bus fund. As you know, we try to make our trips affordable, and we're quite fortunate. We're probably the only senior center around here who has a bus fund, thanks to the hard work of everybody here, okay? So we can go on our trips at a very low cost. All right, this is the final prize of the afternoon, the grand prize of $250 cash. The grand prize of $250 goes to Terry Bertice. Terry's not here either, right? Congratulations, everybody. And thank you for supporting us at the Tuckahoe Senior Center. I hope you had a fun time. Thanks to everybody for their hard work. And you can still buy some items and bake sale items and food, so keep spending.